we are going to discuss the general exceptions of Indian Penal Code. We are going to discuss actually the small portion of general exceptions. General exceptions give the protection of the offenders who have committed the offences but they are not liable under any section of Indian Penal Code. They are not liable for any punishment at all. So let's see what are the acts exempted under the code.
General Exceptions, Indian Penal Code, 1860. Mistake of fact, which is in section 76. Nothing is an offence which is done by a person who is or who by reason of a mistake of fact and not by a mistake of law in good faith believes himself to be bound by law to do it. Suppose A, who is a soldier, fires on a mob by the order of his superior officer in conformity with the commands of the law. A has committed no offence. Section 79 says, act done by a person justified or by mistake of fact, believing himself justified by law. Nothing is an offence if the act done by a person justified or by mistake of fact, believing himself justified by law. Suppose A sees Z commit what appears to him to be a murder. A, in good faith and to the best of his judgment, exercising the power given by law to all persons, apprehends Z in order to bring him to book. At a later stage, even if it turns out that Z was acting in self-defense, it is no offense by A. This is because A acted in good faith, believing himself to be justified by law. That is to say, section 79 gives a legal justification for his act.
Judicial Act, section 77 and 78. Nothing is an offence which is done by a judge when acting judicially in the exercise of any power which is or which in good faith he believes to be given to him by law. Section 78 says, nothing is an offence which is done in pursuance of or which is warranted by the judgment or order of a court of justice, if done whilst such judgment or order remains in force. Notwithstanding, the court may have had no jurisdiction to pass such judgment or order, provided the person doing the act in good faith believes that the court had such jurisdiction. Accident in doing a lawful act, section 80. Suppose A is at work with a hatchet. The head of the hatchet flies off and kills a man who is standing by. Here, if there was no want of proper caution on the part of A, his act is excusable and not be the offence. Section 81 says, act likely to cause harm without criminal intention and to prevent other harm. Suppose A, in a great fire, pulls down houses in order to prevent the conflagration from spreading. He does this in good faith of saving human life and property. Here A has committed no offence. Section 82, act of the child under 7 years of age. Nothing is an offence which is done by a child under 7 years. Section 83, act of a child between 7 years and 12 years of immature understanding. Nothing is an offence done by the above mentioned child. He is between 7 years and 12 years of immature understanding. If the offence is committed by such child having no sufficient maturity of understanding to judge of the nature and consequences of his conduct on that occasion. Section 84, Act of Lunatic. Nothing is an offense which is done by a person who, at the time of doing it by reason of unsoundness of mind, is incapable of knowing the nature of the act, or that he is doing what is either wrong or contrary to law. Section 85 says, act of an intoxicated person. This section declares that voluntary intoxication is no excuse for committing an offense, whereas an involuntary intoxication is a complete defense. Section 86, offense requiring a particular intent or knowledge. This section says that if an intoxicated person commits an offense requiring a particular intent or knowledge, he shall be dealt with as if he had that intent or knowledge, unless the thing which intoxicated him was administered to him without his knowledge or against his will. Section 92 says, bona fide act for another's benefit. Suppose Z is carried off by a tiger. A fires at the tiger, knowing it to be likely that the shot may kill Z, but not intending to kill Z, and in good faith intending Z's benefit, A's firing gives Z a mortal wound. A has committed no offense. Section 93, communication made in good faith. Suppose A surgeon in good faith communicates to a patient his opinion that he cannot live. The patient dies in consequence of the shock. A has committed no offense, though he knew it to be likely that the communication might cause the patient's death. Section 94, act done under compulsion or threat. Except murder and offenses against the state punishable with death, nothing is an offense which is done by a person who is compelled to do it by threats, which at the time of doing it reasonably cause the apprehension that instant death to the person will otherwise be the consequence. Provided that the person doing the act did not of his own accord or from a reasonable apprehension of harm to himself, short of instant death, place himself in the situation by which he became subject to such constraint. Section 90, which is consent. A consent is not a consent if it is given by a person under fear or injury or under a misconception, a fact, or an unsound or intoxicated person, or by a person who is under 12 years of age. Section 87 says, act not intended and not known to be likely to cause death or grievous hurt, done by consent. Suppose A and Z agree to fence with each other for amusement. This agreement implies the consent of each to suffer any harm which in the course of such fencing may be caused without foul play. And if A, while playing fairly, hurts Z, A commits no harm. Section 88, act not intended to cause death, done by consent in good faith for person's benefit. Suppose A surgeon, knowing that the particular operation is likely to cause the death of Z, who suffers under a painful complaint, but not intending to cause Z's death and intending in good faith Z's benefit, performs the operation on Z with Z's consent. A has committed no offense. Section 91, exclusion of the acts which are offenses independently of harm. Causing miscarriage, unless caused in good faith, is an offense independently of any harm which it may cause or be intended to cause to the woman. Therefore, it is not an offense by reason of such harm. And the consent of the woman or of her guardian to the causing of such miscarriage does not justify the act. Section 95. Act causing slight harm. Nothing is an offense by reason that it causes or that it is intended to cause or that it is known to be likely to cause any harm if that harm is so slight that no person of ordinary sense and temper would complain of such harm. No more today. Stay safe and stay healthy. Thank you.